Yeah, Jalen doesn't get many blocks. I don't even know what that was for her career, but
two
blocks in her career. That was a critical play for us though. So, you know, however she can get it, I'm really happy she was up there getting it, stopping the shot.
It seemed like it was indicative of the way y'all were playing. Y'all, everybody was contributing, mm-hmm. everybody was hustling.
Yeah, we really just wanted to be locked in. You know, Kentucky is a great team. I think they maybe only lost two games the whole season. So, you know, I tried to stop Ryan as much as we could and then just try to make it tough for everybody else.
Mm-hmm. Did you enjoy that victory a little bit more than you usually do, or did you jump right into thinking about Tennessee?
Yeah, of course, you know, SEC is a critical time. You know, we in and out, it's hard games, and so you definitely want to try to win the ones at home. Plus, Kentucky was number 11, so it was kind of a big win for us. But, you know, you can only celebrate for, I guess, maybe the rest of that day, and then you have to lock into the next opponent because we have, you know, Tennessee coming up, and they're a great team. Renai Davis is a great player, so we're really going to have to be locked in that game, too.
As far as playing on the road, is that maybe the toughest place to play?
Yeah, I would say that's one of the tougher environments. You know, places like Mississippi State was kind of a nice atmosphere. South Carolina is a nice atmosphere, but Tennessee definitely has a nice fan base as well.
You feel like you are kind of building some momentum now, and winners of three of your last four, and certainly gave Mississippi State all they could handle. If you don't fall behind real quick, I mean, maybe you're talking about a pretty long winning streak at this point.
Yeah, you know, we're trying to just emphasize one game at a time. We knew before coming into the stretch we had, you know, at Mississippi State, Kentucky home, and then at Tennessee, I think top 20 teams in our conference in the country. So, you know, really just trying to take each game one game at a time and then kind of just trying to lock in and focus on that team at the moment, not trying to look ahead, not worrying about what we did last game or falling short. So, yeah, I guess, you know, we're really excited where we are right now and just kind of try to keep running with it.
What do the Lady Vols do so well?
I haven't seen them that much this year. I saw actually the last game, Alabama, the other day. But I know a lot runs through Renaya. She's a beast. I actually played against her a lot in AAU. So kind of know her game a little bit, but you know, we're just going to do as best as we can about her and just try to limit everybody else, really.
Is there anything specific with your game that you're trying to focus on going into Tennessee?
Myself or the team?
Yourself.
You know, I just try to do what I can to help the team. You know, my job is to run the team, get people involved, score when I can here and there. But, you know, as long as we pull out the W, I really don't care what my stat line looks like.
Some general thoughts about Coach Cordova and what she's meant. She works closely with the guards.
Yeah.
What does she bring?
Coach Ceri, she has a funny way, you know, of coaching us. She's a lot different from, you know, Tasha Butts, who we've been used to within the past few years. But, you know, just kind of bringing a different style. You know, there's times where I just go over there, ask her questions, just trying to pick her brain a little bit. I remember it was really funny when she first came over here, because it was like she wanted us to shoot a lot of threes or step back threes, and we were like, oh, like, we don't usually do that. But, you know, she's fun, and, you know, we're still learning her a little bit, but we've developed a bond that's really close.
Has there been a moment where, in the game maybe, where she said something that really clicked for you, that helped you, that you remember?
Let's see. Usually she's just telling me to be confident in myself. Mm-hmm. You know, she's like, come on, mate, take over. Or come on, play your game, run the team. And it's always like, come on, you can do this. She's like really, really encouraging, you know. The staff believes in me, I believe in myself. So just knowing that your coach like has your back like that, and like, come on, you can take over this game, you can do that, that's always very helpful.
Do y'all kind of laugh at her Australianness?
Yes, definitely, definitely. And like, even Foss, we like call her mate. Like, come on, mate, what are you doing, mate? Because she calls us mate. So definitely her dad and her accent and, you know, just her personality. But she's a great person. I'm glad we have her on staff.
Have you had to introduce her to any sort of Louisiana culture or Louisiana life?
I have not. No. Me personally, if we're being honest, they're still trying to introduce me to some things. I just tried oysters the other day.
Right.
Oysters, what is it? Grilled oysters.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, okay, this is not, I couldn't get past what they look like, but but it was okay. But I personally have not tried to get into Louisiana things.
So it was the verdict on oysters, not for you?
It was okay. It was okay.
Maybe fry them a little bit more.
Something. It was okay for the moment. They were seasoned well. They taste okay. But I probably won't order them again. I won't order them again.
Can you imagine eating them raw?
Yeah. No, if someone actually at the table next to us had ordered them raw, and I think Queen actually eats them raw, honestly, Raquel Spencer.
She's from New Orleans.
Yeah, she's from New Orleans. So, but nah, char grilled was the closest I get to tasting. But I probably won't order them again.
I'm with you.